Hello everyone. In this session, we will try to discuss about the work cycle program. This work cycle program is a part in the program instructions. Now, this program instruction is also a one parameter in the basic elements of the automation. Especially in the work cycle program, there are two parameters are coming into picture. The first is nothing but the set point control. Once if the set point control is to be achieved, there are two parameters. One is nothing but the process parameter, and also the process variable is the most efficient one. As you know that work cycle program is a simplest automated process. That cycle consists of essentially a one step in which maintaining a single processing parameter, and that can be defined a level. Maintaining a temperature in a furnace is one example in a heat treatment cycle. In this case, the program is simply involves that setting a particular temperature for the duration. Now here in this case, there are two terms are coming into picture. The process parameter, that is the input process, such as the temperature and as well as the dial setting, whereas the process variable is nothing but corresponding output. Now, the control system. The control systems are the elements of the automated system to execute the program instructions or even the work cycle. Now, the control systems causes the process to accomplish its definite functions or predefined functions. Now, the control systems are also of two types. One is the open loop control system. The another one is a closed loop system. Normally, the closed loop control systems are also called as a feedback control systems, which is nothing but a parameter, output parameter is compared with respect to the input parameter. Now here in the case of even the input parameter and as well as the output parameter is compared, and then afterwards where the regulations it can be done by using the devices. Now in this, the output variable is compared with the input parameter, and that if there is any difference between the two is used to drive the output in an agreement with respect to the input. Now the basic elements of the system are either it may be a closed loop system or it may be an open loop system. Normally a input parameter, the process parameter, the output variable, feedback sensors, controller and actuators. The input parameter represents a desired value of the output. In the home temperature control system, normally a desired thermostat setting is a measure where the input parameter is controlled and the same output is also regulated. The process is the operation or the function being controlled. In particular, it is the output variable that is being controlled by the loop. In the present discussion, the process interest is usually a manufacturing operation, and the output variable is some process variable, perhaps a critical performance, either it may be measured in the process or a temperature or a force or it may be a flow rates, depending upon the type of the application where we are automating it. Now a sensor is used to measure the output variable in and a closed the loop between the input and as well as the output. The sensor performs the feedback function in a closed loop control systems. The controller compares the output with respect to the input and makes the required adjustment in the process. The adjustment is accomplished using one or more actuators, which is nothing but the hardware devices, where the control actions, such as either it may be by means of an electric motor or by means of the flow valves. The most of the industries processing requires a multiple loops, one for each process variable, that is a must be controlled. Now in this slide there are two the block diagram it has been represented. One is with respect to the open loop control system. The another one is a feedback control system. The feedback, as you know, that feedback control system is also called as the closed loop control system. With respect to the closed loop control system, the input parameter, the controller, the actuator, the process, output variable, and as well as feedback sensors. These are the essential things in a closed loop control system. But in the case of an open loop control system, only the five elements are sufficient. The input parameter, which is controlled, and as well as the actuator, and the process is executed, the output variable. Now, in contrast with the closed loop control system, an open loop control system operates without the feedback loop. In this case, the control operates without measuring the output variable, so there is no comparison is made between the actual value and the output value, or it may be a desired output is not compared with respect to the input. The control relies on an accurate model of the effect of the actuator on the process variable. With the open loop system, there is always a risk that the actuator will not have an intended effect on the process. That is the disadvantage in the case of the open loop control system. And its advantage is that a generally similar and less expensive than that of the closed loop systems. Now, open loop systems are usually appropriate when the following conditions apply. The first one is the action performed by the control system are very simple. Now, the second one is the actuating function is a very reliable. The third one is any reaction force opposing the actuator are a small enough to have no effect on the actuation. If these three are satisfied, characteristics are not applicable, then we have to go for the closed loop control systems. For example, in this which consists of the motor, and the another one is a work table is connected through the lead screw. The another one is the optical encoder. Now, the movement of the table is actuated through the motor. The input variable or the input parameter is nothing but the movement of the table in the x direction. That is controlled by the controller, and the signal is given to the motor, which is nothing but an input to the motor that drives the lead screw, by which automatically the table will move. But if there is any variation with respect to the table movement, or if there is an error in the table movement, that optical encoder sends the feedback for the controller for the action. In the process of error detection, along with error detection, error recovery is also another major parameter in the process of automation. As you know, that error recovery is concerned with the applying the necessary corrective actions to overcome the failures or the errors. Now, the problem is of designing an error recovery system focuses the devising appropriate strategies or the procedures is a very important parameter, either to compensate the error that can be occurred in the process. Generally, a specific recovery strategy and the procedures must be designed for the each different types of errors. Now, even the errors are classified as follows. First one, the make adjustment at the end of the current work cycle. When the current work cycle is completed, the part program branches to a corrective action, a subroutine specifically designed to detect the error and execute the subroutine, and then return to the work cycle program. Make the adjustment during the current cycle itself. This is a generally indicated and higher level of urgency than the preceding time. In this case, the action or the corrective action normally compensated for the detected error is initiated as soon as it is detected. However, the designated corrective action must be possible to accomplish while the work cycle is still being executed. Now, the third one is stop the process to invoke the corrective action in case of the deviation or the malfunction. The fourth one is stop the process and call for the help. In this case, the error cannot be resolved through the automated recovery procedures. This situation arises because of the automated cell is not enabled to correct the problem, or the error cannot be classified into a predefined list of errors. In either of the cases, the human assistance is essential to correct the problem and to restore the system to a fully automated operations.